The computing cloud is forever changing, and that means, of course, that the available certifications for the cloud change too, and Azure is no exception. Some time ago, I created a very comprehensive Azure certification guide, which you can find using the link in the description. It's still very relevant, but a few things have changed. A few new certs are out, and the recertification process is different. So while I plan on creating a whole new updated and in-depth guide very soon, I figured you could use this update for, well, the latest. Sounds good? Excellent. Let's dig in. First up is the biggest update to an existing course for quite some time. The Azure Solutions Architect Expert is a certification that many aspire to complete, and it is also one of our most popular topics on the channel. Having already gone through one iteration from AZ 300 and 301 to AZ 303 and 304, the entire curriculum has now been consolidated to a single exam. Yes, one, AZ 305. Now, while this is probably welcome news, having to study for, you know, only one exam, let alone only sitting one, it doesn't mean it has become any easier. AZ 305 is still one of the most demanding exams, along with AZ 400 DevOps Engineer Expert. And it covers designing identity, governance, and monitoring solutions. And this includes log routing, role-based access control, identity security, application security, user consent, and monitoring tools. Design of data storage solutions, such as database scalability and service tiering, encryption of data at various stages of its lifecycle, storing of relational and non-relational data, access control and durability of data. Business continuity solutions, and that covers recovery solutions for compute, databases and containers, as well as designing high availability systems. The last section of this exam is designing infrastructure solutions such as VM-based, container-based, and serverless computing architectures. It also covers application architecture, data migration scenarios, network solutions, caching, and a whole lot more. In short, AZ 305 touches on almost all parts of Azure, except maybe blockchain? Anyway, the new update is boiled down, but possibly into a higher concentrate of cloud architecture and perspiration from many, many hours of study. One more change from the AZ 303-304 days is that you now must have passed AZ 104 Azure Administrator before you can sit the 305 exam. And this makes sense, as 305 builds on all of the knowledge in 104. Now for the biggest news, I reckon, when it comes to new Azure certifications. The tail end of Microsoft computing is still firmly wagging within the Windows Server community, and there are a lot of people still relying on Windows Server every single day. Until now, they've kind of been left out of the computing love from Microsoft certifications, but that changes with, ready? Windows Server Hybrid Administrator Associate Certification. Yeah. This certification consists of two exams, AZ 800, Administering Windows Server Hybrid Core Infrastructure, and AZ 801, Configuring Windows Server Hybrid Advanced Services. There's a barrage of topics covered in those two exams, which goes to show that a real gap in the Azure certification landscape has been filled. Some of the topics include deploy and manage Active Directory domain services in on-premises and cloud environments. Managing Windows servers in a hybrid environment, which includes deploying Windows Admin Center gateway servers, configuring Kerberos, assigning user policies, working with log analytics, and much more. Managing virtual machines and containers in Azure, such as guest VMs, Hyper-V switching, creating Windows Server container images, managing VM data disks, and network configuration. Implement and manage an on-premises and hybrid networking infrastructure, including DNS, IP address management, and hybrid connectivity. And that is only the AZ 800 exam. Yeah, I know, it's a big certification, but so needed and welcome. AZ 801 is all about security, high availability, disaster recovery, and workload migrations. If you've already passed AZ 104 Azure Administrator and perhaps have worked with Windows Server in the past or currently, this certification is for you. If you wonder which cloud role this fits in with, it is sort of on its own, but most closely related to Azure Administrator or even Azure Architect. One thing is sure though, it is a very, very large curriculum, and I am thinking it is a bit optimistic being pitched at the associate level rather than expert. Time will tell if that's accurate. From the fire into the lava, or something. I forgot how that goes. The next new cert is also a doozy. The ASET 700 Azure Network Engineer Associate builds on all the networking knowledge you got from AZ 104 and takes you down the VNet rabbit hole. This is my way of saying that before you even consider AZ 700, I would recommend passing AZ 104. The exam, called Designing and Implementing Microsoft Azure Networking Solutions, covers topics such as design, implement, and manage a site-to-site VPN connection, a point-to-site VPN connection, and Azure ExpressRoute. Using private IP addressing for VNets, designing public and private DNS zones, implementing service chaining and VNet peering, and designing and implementing Azure WAN architectures. Managing network routing, including building route tables and resolving routing issues. Designing a load balancing network for internal and public apps, as well as cross-region traffic, using CDNs, Azure Front Door, and Azure Traffic Manager. Securing and monitoring networks, using firewalls, security groups, and web application firewalls. And finally, how to create private access links and service endpoints. Whew, there's a huge amount of networking details included in this exam. I know, I sat it, and I didn't do well. I need to up my networking game. It's as simple as that. The last two certifications I'll cover in this update are more niche and specialized. The first is AZ 600, which does sound like a main topic area, but is all about Azure Stack Hub. And if you aren't familiar with the product, I don't blame you. Stack Hub is Azure's way of letting you install Azure on your own environment using 6,237 floppy disks. Probably. If you're an operator of your company data center and you're considering installing Azure Stack Hub, then you would consider AZ 600, but that is most likely the only scenario though. This exam also builds on AZ 104 to some extent, as well as how to deploy and manage Stack Hub itself. You'll be tested on greatest hits like managing the Azure Stack Hub marketplace, planning app service resources, and event hub resources. Manage quotas, plans, usage, and billing, which is exciting. Preparing your environment for Azure Stack Hub deployment, including DNS identity, certificates, and registration. Managing identity and access for users, applications, and groups. Looking after the system health, designing disaster recovery, and managing backups. Managing capacity to mimic the idea of infinite resources. This includes updating the platform and adding new hardware. Creating and managing privileged endpoints, and that's Azure Stack Hub. And next up is probably my favorite specialty exam. Cosmos DB. It embodies everything that is cloud computing, including low latency, native cross-geography synchronization, high-performing compute, and infinitely scalable. It offers an easy way for developers to use one of five APIs. You get 99.999% guaranteed uptime, and it integrates with a lot of other Azure services. It's all perfect then. No, of course not. And there are lots of ways that you can mess it up, including getting huge bills when you don't expect it. And that's probably why there is now a dedicated DP420 designing and implementing cloud native applications using Microsoft Azure Cosmos DB exam. Pass this exam and you will earn the Azure Cosmos DB Developer Specialty Certification. And this exam covers using non-relational data models with the Azure Cosmos DB Core API, such as getting storing and denormalization right, and using access patterns. Designing and configuring partitioning strategies, including cost, synthetic partitioning, and cross-partitioning. Managing scaling and sizing, connectivity options, and data access for all APIs. Many, many developer-specific features, including multi-document loading, session consistency, pagination, store procedures, and more. Replication strategies, multi-region writes and consistency models, integration with other Azure services, performance optimization with indices, request unit costs, and integrated caching, monitoring, security, backup, and restore operations. No, that's it. I was just kidding there. Now, this is truly a proper specialty exam that goes in depth on most, if not all, of the parts of Cosmos DB. If you also want to get the most out of one of the best cloud services around, DP420 is the choice. Okay, one more thing before I leave you. Once you achieve a certification, it has an expiry date, apart from a couple of fundamentals such as AZ-900. This means that you need to maintain the certification to keep it valid and current. This is a good idea because the cloud and computing in general changes so much and so often. Instead of having to sit the exam every 2 years or so, Microsoft now asks you to recertify every year. Well, hang on. It's nowhere near as bad as it sounds. Instead of taking a full-blown exam every 2 years, you now do a few Microsoft Learn modules and then sit the tests. It isn't a full exam, but rather 25 questions or so on a subset of this certification curriculum. For example, when I recertified AZ-204, Azure Developer, I had 25 questions on three areas, only three, Cosmos DB, Durable Functions, and Logic Apps. The questions aren't easy, but no one's watching you and there's no time limit on it. So like if you fail, you just do the exam again once every 24 hours. Well, until the 1 year mark for your certification date is reached, of course. Now this process starts 6 months after you pass your exam the first time, and then you have 6 months to complete the tests. It's a lot less stressful and you don't have to pay for it. Bonus! However, if you don't pass the recertification within the 6 month period, you're back to sitting the full exam. That's all I have for you this time. Now, I am working on a complete revamp of our full Azure certification roadmap, but that's a lot of work, so it might take a while. Until then, keep being awesome. Bye, cloud gurus.